Oh, hi! Yeah, welcome back to Dark Souls with Alex Silvermont and Sivmont. This character's name. You know, I'm never gonna get over the fact that I made that typo. And I really should have just deleted it. Whatever. So here we have some humanity. What is humanity? This black sprite is called humanity, but little is known about its true nature. If the soul is the source of all life, then what distinguishes the humanity we hold within ourselves? Good question, game. Good question. And we'll talk more about that later, unless I forget. But here we are in Firelink Shrine. The game's... You could call it the hub, you could call it the nexus. It's the starting area. Let's see what this is. Yeah, that's one way to do it. So if you see where I'm looking now, we'll be going all the way down there. That is an area. I mean, we can't get there from just falling. Can we? Maybe. But that would kill us, obviously. That is an area called Blighttown. And I hate Blighttown. Now, many people also don't find this cute little thing until quite a while into the game. She has been locked away behind these bars, and she has no tongue. But she is the fire keeper. She keeps the fire lit. So she's important. She is our best friend, you could say. I just wanted to see what would happen. You know? And we are not losing anything by dying at this point. Here. So, when you die, you'll notice that your souls vanish. But they're not gone forever. So here's where we died. More or less. Now, this is not really where you want to go at the start of the game. I'm not sure why I've gone down there. So let's go back up. I think I've done something wrong with the graphics, as the shadows on this grass looks really strange. Or is that just me? See, I'm used to the console version, which, it's a nice-looking game, but it... Yeah. Let's see what this guy has to say.
Well, what do we have here?
An illiterate.
It must be a new arrival. Let me guess. Fate of the undead, right? Well, you're not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead asylum. But too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, two bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below, in the ruins at the base of Blighttown. Ring them both, and something happens. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on, but I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land of the undead?
One thing that that many, many undead in this game share is they laugh in a situation where you don't normally think someone would laugh. Now, I am of the opinion this is something to do with their slipping sanity. They laugh because they're going insane, or they laugh because they're trying to keep themselves sane, or any number of reasons. Whereas the human characters, of which there are some, don't seem to laugh as much. But, you know, that's just a strange, stupid theory. I am not a psychologist. Don't pay me to have you sit on a couch, because you'll probably die.
Ah, your face. You're practically hollow. But oh no, going hollow could solve quite a bit.
Aye, we do look like a sausage. That's never a good sign.
What? Restoring your humanity? Well, there are a few ways to go about it. Collect it bit by bit from corpses. Or you can butter up a cleric and get yourself summoned. And the quickest way, although I'd never do it, is to kill a healthy undead and pillage it. Coveting thy neighbor is a...
So, he tells you how to get humanity. He doesn't tell you in a very easy to understand way, if you're a new player, perhaps, but he does tell you, bit by bit, from corpses. In other words, if you kill enemies, eventually you will collect one humanity. Or you can butter up a cleric and get yourself summoned. Now that is slightly more vague, the part about the cleric, but getting yourself summoned by another player, that does work to get yourself a humanity if you help them kill the boss. So, as I mentioned earlier, we'll be going down there. That's Blighttown, where the second bell is. And that big tree over there is... Well, we'll be going into that big tree too. One thing about this game is that you can often see me do stupid stuff like that. But yeah, one thing about this game is you can often see hours and hours before you get there, unless you're a speedrunner, which I'm not. It took me 30 minutes to get through the asylum. I mean, normally it takes me about 3, but, you know, recording and all that. Anyway, you can see far in advance places you will be going up and down. So he told us this 2 bells, one up, one down. I think it is a fair assumption to want to start from the bottom and work your way up. But not so here. Well, let's explore Firelink Shrine and see what we can see. Firebomb, always helpful. And here we have Petrus of Thorland. Thorwand. Petrus. Yeah. He's, I believe, an actual human.
Hello there. I believe we are not acquainted. I am Petrus of Thorland.
Thorland.
Have you business with us?
Yes.
If not, I'd prefer to keep a distance, if possible.
Why? You're fat, I don't like you.
Hello there. I realize that I have requested that we retain our distance.
You did.
But I also want you to know that it is not meant in ill will. Here, take this as a token of peace. No, go ahead.
So, he basically says, get out of my face. Here, have a coin to get out of my face. I always wonder if that's a typo, McLoyf. It probably isn't, but McLoy just seems well, whatever. Even coins of great value in the world of men have little value in Lordran, where the accepted currency is souls. Those who dream of returning to the outside world are fond of carrying these around. So, this tells us several things. For starters, it tells us that souls are currency, as well as what we use for levelling up. It also tells us that he has some ambition, most likely, to return to the human world. Or he did, and perhaps he's starting to lose that ambition, which is why he gave us the coin. Or, you know, maybe he's got hundreds of copper coins and he thinks one's enough to get rid of us. And Dark Souls is a game that punishes you from being silly, but it also rewards you for being adventurous. And Firelink Shrine, I believe, highlights a lot of the game's systems, you might say. So there we have a talisman. A talisman. This is used for casting one of the three schools of magic. Cracked Red Eye Orb. That is used to invade another player's game, which, as the Crestfallen Warrior told us, you can take it from a healthy undead. So if you invade someone, you can kill them and take their humanity. Which isn't a very nice thing to do. Oh dear. See, this should be the first sign that this is not the way you're meant to go. We are hardly hurting these guys whatsoever. And they basically destroy us. So we're gonna probably get killed by them. We're gonna run away from them for now. And we'll take that. Thank you very much. I don't want to fall down again. But he does. So we've picked up a fair few items here. They all have their uses. There are very rarely junk items in Dark Souls, and it's worth carrying on to things.
Oh my. You again?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I know. How about this? I have to await my companions here anyway. So what if I were to teach you some miracles? Would that please you?
It would.
Very well. Then first, a covenant with the gods.
So he wants us to join his covenant. These are typically related to online play.
Now, let only their ultimate... My companions are Milady and her young knights. She is young, but burdened. We are her defenses, to keep her from harm.
Note the British-English way of spelling defense.
An undead mission? Regrettably, I cannot share that with you. But you are my...
So we'll feed this fat sucker some souls and see what he's got to say.
Very well. I can surely tell you, of all people...
Very trusting.
Clerics are given a mission to seek kindling. Kindling is the art of feeding bonfires with humanity. Through kindling, we shall one day be granted magnificent power.
You'll notice his mouth does not move whilst he's talking. That is just a gameplay thing. But it'll come up a bit later.
Very well. Come again.
So some undead come here because they are on a mission to kindle. And we will find out more about that later. First, let us go and pick up some pretty handy items. Now, there is always the option of picking up the Great Scythe and making it fire one, blah blah blah. We're not gonna do that because, frankly, I don't like scythes, and I don't like them in Dark Souls. I think they're I hesitate to say overpowered, because like everything, they do have a counter, but I dislike them because they are very powerful, and, you know, I just think they're a try-hard weapon. And I have a thing, I like to fight fair for the most part. I'm not really sure why, that's just, you know, who I am. I don't like to cheat. And no, I don't think using a scythe is cheating. Not, even twinking isn't technically cheating, but, you know, I just don't find it fun. If someone essentially cannot fight back, there's no fun in that for me. So, we just picked up a couple of handy items. Let's have a look at what we got. Binoculars, of course. Handy for staring at things. We also got a winged spear, which we can't effectively use yet. Why not? Because we need 15 dexterity. We also got a Zweihander. You know, I have no idea how to pronounce that. Zweihander. Two-hander. It's a very, very popular weapon in PvP. Because it's, I mean, look at it, it's huge. Not only does it look pretty cool, I think, the huge range on it means you can, you can just wail away at people, crush their poise and so forth. Now, I haven't actually talked about poise, but I will later. Let's move on for now. Failure. The nice thing about using headphones is that I can actually hear a lot of the sound effects I normally don't hear. And yes, this game has amazing physics. So these guys are a lot easier. So, perhaps going up is the right way after all. And yes, you are completely immune to all damage. As long as you are in several animations. Now this guy is being a douche. And that guy has a rather nice axe. Oh, hello. Which he didn't want to drop for us today, but that's okay. So, if we wanted that axe, we could go to the bonfire, use it, and respawn all these enemies. We're not going to do that. I'd want to keep grinding to a minimum if possible. You know, grinding, farming, and general MMO tomes. Oh. Apparently, he's still alive. Well, not anymore. See, this is where attacks like that come in handy, because, okay, that kind of defeats the point, but if you're in a tight quarters like this, you can't be, you know, banging off the walls. You want to be, yeah, that's what you want to be doing. Does not open from this side. It's clearly a shortcut of some kind. Good luck. Thanks. Good luck. Thanks. Okay. Okay. I'll do that. Ooh. I really do not like that super fast jumping attack they have. Because it always seems to kill me. And I am having some frame rate... Oh. Yeah, I'm having some frame rate issues. I'm not sure why that is. Hopefully it's not because a certain Finnish person is spamming me on Messenger. If they are, I will stab them. You might be thinking, where the hell am I? And you would be right to think that. This area, this game can be very disorienting the first time you play it. It can be hard to know where you are and where you're meant to be going. See, the areas are not actually that big if you compare to other games, but they are very dense. Dense. And here we have some more humanity. Always good to have. It's actually rather hard on this rubbish controller to jump. That's what I was trying to do. We could also jump down there, but you know, we've already been down there, I don't want to go again. I'm not entirely sure why people struggle with this game. I try to watch other people's, like, first time playing so I can pinpoint what it is they're struggling with. I think a lot of it is just people... Let's assume this barrel is an enemy, which, in fairness, it is. They see an enemy and they will just run in and hit it. Dark Souls is the sort of game where you need to wait for the enemy to attack. And once they've attacked, they're open and you can hit them. And honestly, that, I think, is the best advice you can give anyone who's struggling in Dark Souls. Just wait for the enemy to attack. Wait for an opening. So, it seems like we can make this jump, but we actually can't. And I probably spent about half an hour trying, first time I ever played. So, not... Well, yeah, let's just call him a dragon. Can I... I swear I can hear an enemy. I don't want to get hit from behind and die. That would make Sivmon sad. Let's drink some Sunny D. So, you saw the dragon thing. Not actually dragon, but whatever. And he flew up there. And he's vanished from sight. That'll... We'll remember why. So... You should always use the terrain to your advantage in any game. That's pretty simple, you know? Though, one very strange thing is that in Dark Souls, the high ground is often at a disadvantage. Like, if I was fighting someone on these steps, I would rather be below them than above them. Although you can actually aim your attacks up and down if you're not locking on. So, and there's a bonfire. It's we picked up another wooden shield earlier. The... Now, I'm not sure how you pronounce that. The Caducus? Caduceus? Which actually sounds a little bit like my surname, funnily enough. but we're not going to use that because wooden shields are not as good as metal shields. So you see these guys are blocking and turtling. You can break their guard, or you can knock away their guard with a kick. And yes, enemies do heal. Two-handing your weapon increases your poise. Oh dear. Increases your ability to break shield guards. Well, this guy is getting pretty cheeky. Let's get rid of him. Now let's go down here. That's a very nice combo attack, I like that one. That one gets you close to the enemy with good range, and the follow-up is fast and has decent damage. Very handy. And here we have our first merchant.
Well now, you seem to have your wits about you. Hmm? Then you are here from the customer. I'll pay for souls. Everything's for sale.
I broke your shit. Let's see what he has. So the thing I just bought allows me to write my own messages and leave them for other players. This will open a door that we'll see later. The rest will pick up these items later, especially the bottomless box, which is very handy. He also sells a variety of weapons, and should we get any of these? Yes, we will buy the short bow, and we'll also buy we'll buy the rapier. That will fit into my plans for the build. And we'll buy 200 some wooden arrows. Bit of armor.
Thank you kindly.
See, now we have no souls to level up with. But that's okay, because, I mean, you can always get more. There's nothing to stop you farming in this game if you want to. And there we see Ghost of Another Player. And you'll notice when they get close to the bonfire, you can actually see them more than just a spirit sort of thing. Oh. Okay, let's have a quick break and then continue.